What's your mom's catchphrase? When she gets lost driving the world round, we'll get there eventually. Don't come crying to me later. Grain by grain, you can create a mountain. Every time she finishes a chore, she says it like a mantra. Mother of four and we are close in age. My dad worked 14 days, so she did all the housework herself. She went back to work when we were older and apparently her co-workers tell us she also says it. Every time she finishes something, I brought you into this world and I'll take you the fuck out of it. Usually while holding this giant metal rolling pin she had. I see we are siblings. Moom, what's for dinner? Shit with sugar on top. Your mom is savage. Play stupid games, win stupid prizes. It's only money, generally used after paying a large medical bill. Or if we got in a fender bender. She isn't a big spender, but she never put too much weight in money, as she viewed it as a tool, not her self-worth or identity. Your mother is a wise woman. You'll get over it. I know I will. Steal someone's parking space. He'll get over it. I know I will. I'm mad because she's making me plant all these plants that I know she will kill in a week. You'll get over it. I know I will. Cracks me up every time. She stole it from her dad. And now I'm stealing it from her. This really cracked me. It doesn't matter what you end up doing in life as long as you're happy. She can be wise sometimes. I got a different message. No, honey, you don't want to be a insert dream job that doesn't make a lot of money. I am not your goddamn retirement plan. Me, asterisk does something stupid, asterisk my mom, common sense, not common in everyone. Mom, would you like something to eat? Quote, me, nah, I'm not hungry, thanks. 0.5 minutes later, mom, would you like something to eat? Quote, repeated every 5 minutes until I go home. On a side note, this has reminded me to give her a call. Edit, by the way. Didn't realize it was Mother's Day in the US today. Here in the UK we had it weeks ago. I wasn't just ignoring my mom. This is literally every mom, monsieur. Te calmo, zo te calmo. Do what I say, not what I do, basically her excuse to be a shitty parent. Mine was the same way. I'm glad she smoked herself into an early grave. Well, she was really good at faux profanity like dadgummit. Quote, OMG. I heard this so much growing up, but only from my dad. Long story short, even when there wasn't a story, even when nobody has been speaking. My personal favorite is when there is a story. It's long as hell. And they keep saying, long story short, but then it morphs into multiple other rabbit trail stories. It's not what you say, it's how you say it. CEO of not putting up with my angsty teen attitude. This phrase used to drive me crazy. For fuck's sakes, my name, she means it with love, I think. When she gets startled, she'll say, heavens to Murgatroyd. Which we've come to understand was stolen from a Yogi Bear character. My grade 8 teacher said that all the time and I had no idea where it was from. Monsieur, you just solved a 22-year-old mystery for me. Know what I mean? Jellybean. Quote, my BF says if you asked his mom what's for dinner, a common response would be fried farts and pickled assholes, lol, she's very eccentric. The reply to your first is always, I understand, rubber band. Harder, deeper. My mom was a coal miner too. Nice save. Hole up. You can't fly with the eagles when you run with the turkeys. It served me well so far. People in hell want ice water. And they don't get it either. As a small child I used to point at things in stores and go, ooh, I want that. She'd respond with that phrase. Now that I'm grown it's a joke. The other day we were driving to the grocery store and she mentioned wanting pizza from a certain restaurant that was closed. I grinned and said, people in hell want ice water. And they don't get it either. She laughed and called me a smartass. Play with a knife. You might end your life. She used to tell me this whenever I told her I was going to cook. 20 years later, I tell her this since I have been to culinary school and have worked with many professional chefs before. be careful. Our family crest is a lion throwing a leg out to stop another lion from getting hit by a car. I tell my husband to be careful every morning when he goes to work. Right now, going to work translates to walking down the hallway. I say it anyway. Fucking cats will trip you if they can manage. Now we're cooking with gas. How old? My dad was born in 27 and said that. So did a dinosaur in an educational game I had as a kid. Coming from a Polish family, it's kurwa. Clean up your fucking room. I guess everyone can relate with this one. You could stop at 5 or 6 stores. Or just wow. You catch more flies with honey than vinegar. But you can catch more honeys being fly. Random yearbook quote on the internet. Whenever she watches hockey and her team scores, she yells, "That's hockey, baby." My mom's dead. You reap what you sow. Felt like I heard that phrase every day of my teen life. Life's a bitch and then you die. I heard that so much growing up I considered getting a weird tattoo of it when I was younger. Ah, say a cordero que existo. Si tu quieres yo sé que ustedes no se acuerdan de mí. This or any variation of this is utter every time either me or my brother calls, no matter how long. It has been since last we call our visit. My mom's catchphrase is guilt tripping. She is a true Latina Catholic mom that way. Are you yanking my dick? Instead of are you kidding me? My mom's a special lady. Eat it now while it's hot, or you'll have to eat it later when it's cold. The I am your mother, I gave birth to you. Somehow this entitles them to everything. Things I don't even own yet. I am getting the belt. That was my dad's catchphrase. My dad's was, I'm going to the shops to get milk. See you soon. Ah, non-smoker. It is what it is. When we're ready to go, she says, are you ready, Freddy? My mom would say this in Spanish. No te estoy diciendo, te estoy mandando. Translation, I'm not telling you. I'm ordering you. Basically telling us to do something for her. Straighten up and fly right. Or more often through clenched teeth with quiet intensity. Straighten up. I used to shit my pants heading a lyric from a wartime pilot song. It smells like, insert whatever. Don't forget to, something I had not forgotten to do. Don't you have homework to do? Not used anymore since I finished college 2 years ago. My mom does all of these. She asked about my homework probably the first 2 to 3 years out of college. I'm sorry you feel that way. If your mother can't tell you, who will? Every curse word in the English language. Why can't y'all be like your brother? My brother is dead, JK. Quote, quote. Remember, behind the darkest clouds, the sun is always shining and the sky is always blue. Do you work tomorrow? Or what time do you work tomorrow? Are you ready? Instead of ready. Also making the most amusingly dumb nicknames and songs for pets. Oh man. When I was growing up, my mom had a bunch of standard Indian phrases she liked to throw around. If I asked where to put something down, she'd tell me to put it on her head. If I ever wore something less than boring to school, she'd ask me if I was going to school for school or fashion. So many more I can't think of right now. Me, mummy book laji hi kana duna. Mom, bon auto rahi hoon aabq a gas pay bath jau. Lol. If we had a gas stove, I know she would have used that one. Okie chobi instead of okay. She'll say stuff like fiddlesticks and fudge nuggets instead of cursing too. I love her to pieces. My mom always says listen and understand every time she is mad at us not listening. I unconsciously finish listen and understand with the Terminator is out there. Every time I hear it, thank you very much, Michelle Bean. Technically my aunt, since the closest thing to my mom. Give a man ho, they'll do the deed. Give a middle-aged Romanian woman some good ingredients and she'll make a feast. I don't know why the fuck she says it. She's dead, but it used to be. I'm sick and tired of. The boomers were very unwell. Grandma's was. If you can't say something nice, don't say anything at all in a bunch of aphorisms. Which were more entertaining than Mo Monsieur. I'm exhausted, and here I thought I was an only child. Is this usually a response to you calling her out on something or trying to discuss something important? Yup. Sorry, sweetheart, you need to first break both your arms. Do you want a less than thing she is ordering me to do greater than? A dismissive, uh-huh. Why you no doctor yet? Why don't you love me? I. Not entirely unlike Alpha 5 and Power Rangers. No, we aren't Jews. That goddamn phone. Don't bother me unless there's blood or fire. It better be a big fire or a lot of blood. Usually said before sleeping, after working night shifts at the hospital or when kicking us out of the house to go be kids when it was nice out. Way cow hey. Oh gee. Not for nothing. Less than insert advice greater than. I wish the condom didn't break. I should have swallowed you. *. This is why you're not the favorite. Don't make me call your dad. I don't need to see that. Ajibob. Hopia Manny Popcorn. Shut up or I'm gonna smack the shit out of you. Amo monsieur. And y'all wonder why I get mad at y'all. May I speak to the manager? My full name, followed by the thwacked of a wooden spoon. Whatever I say, it's true, correct. You're a gentleman and a scholar. Every time the dog barks or annoys her, she'll always say, hey, followed by cut it out seconds later. Almost as annoying as the dog barking sometimes. I swear it would kill y'all to do anything around here, wouldn't it? Not my mom, but dad always says, as I always say whenever he uses a cliche saying, the apple doesn't fall far from the tree. As I always say, takes one to know one. As I always say, is your friend jumping well, would you jump too? My mom says, if your friend eats shit, will you eat too? Stop running in and out my goddamn house. Quote, I'ma give you something to cry about. Quote, go get the belt, chunkla. Time to bust a bitch. While driving, she's terrible at it. Lovely. The light at the end of the tunnel might be a train. When I was a kid and constantly asked her what if questions, she'd counter with what if Eleanor Roosevelt could fly. Quote, what's wrong with you? Sometimes followed by you don't have any reason to be sad. Better than a sharp stick in the ass. When I would get in trouble, she would always tell me that if us do it again, she was going to send me to Timbuktu. Always thought she made that place up until I realized it was a real place in Mali. I thought that Kathmandu from the Bob Seger song was a made-up place for way, way too long. My favorite one, my mom says, is drink some water, stop complaining, it is so funny and so practical. Does I love you, but I can't support your lifestyle count? My mom says those normal catchphrases, but always gets them wrong. Mom, okay, let's talk about the monkey in the room. God fucking fubbit, you have no sense of humor. You need to eat more frijoles just because I struggle opening a bottle of tea even though she can't even open it either. I told you. If you're looking for something she knows is right there. If it was a snake, it would have bitten you by now. Quote, fill your boots when dinner is served. Or, we'll touch base when we haven't spoken to each other on a while. My mom's favorite word is motherfucker. Don't call me crazy, I'm not crazy, she's crazy. Was raised by my grandma and she always said, choose your battles. Me. I'm hungry. Mom. Hi. Hungry. I'm au monsieur. Me. I'm tired. Mom. Hi. Tired. I'm au monsieur. Me. Why? Mom. Why has a long tail and two branches? Me. Where are you going? Quote. Mom. Baghdad. Also. Me. What time is it? Quote. Mom. Half past the monkey's ass. Watch how you go, instead of goodbye and always be good, although I'm 30. Happy cake day. You do what you gotta do. Fool me once, shame on me. Fool me twice, shame on you. Fool me three times, everybody's just fucked. Words are silver, but the good example is gold. And there's another one who I always carry with me. When it goes, doesn't come back. When it comes back, it doesn't work. That's what happens when you lend something. Trust me, it rhymes in Portuguese. Holy shit, son, what the fuck have you done now? Whenever we asked her to do something for us, like when will lunch be ready? As soon as I grow a third arm. Quote, thank you so much for watching and have a good day.